Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of So Tell Us Time with the hosts, Troy and Trevor Howard. Let's get started.
Hey, everybody. So happy to be with you today. Happy. We are going to be talking about failing today.
Yes.
Failing is the best. Makes us feel good. Don't you love to fail? Well, we're actually going to be talking about fail forward fast. The secret to success is failing fast and always moving forward. The problem is people try something, they fail at it, and then they kind of linger on it sometimes. They you know, tinker with it, or they get discouraged and they give up. I mean, really what sets us apart, or what sets, I should say us, yes, because we are awesome, but what sets the successful people apart from the people that don't find success is they continue to move forward, even through failures, right?
Absolutely.
So I think we've got some pretty cool information for you today that should motivate you. If you're a basketball fan, you are going to love this episode. Troy is like Mr. Basketball Man. He used to be awesome. He was awesome at basketball until he tore his ligaments and his ankles. And, you know, it ended his NBA career. So, you know, then he had to give it up, and Michael Jordan stepped up during that time and
took his
place.
All right, so let's talk about Michael Jordan. Obviously, you know, one of the greatest basketball players of all time. And here's something he once said. I love this quote. He said, "I've missed more than 9,000 shots in my career.
Wow.
I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. I failed over and over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed." Mm-hmm. I love that quote. It blew my mind. Like, I know, okay, yeah, you're going to miss a lot of shots in the NBA, you know. You're going to lose games. That's going to happen. But the fact that he said 26 times I've taken that game-winning shot and totally missed, and just missed it. Like,
lost the game.
Yeah, lost the game. And think about how hard that must be, right? But he said that failing is what made him a success.
Yeah.
Right? Because now how can that be? How can being a failure actually build your success? So let's talk about that. First off, Trevor talked about fail fast and fail forward, right? Yep. So fail fast basically means, it's the principle behind this is that you want to fail fast in your business so that you don't spend needless time and money on something that is not working. Mm-hmm. So that could be like your marketing. You know, you might be putting money into marketing and it's just not working.
Right.
And, but you're like, I don't know. And you just keep doing it and you invest more and more money into it, even though you're really not getting that return, or you don't know if you're getting a return.
Yep.
And you're failing, but you're not failing fast.
No.
You're just continually failing over and over and over again, and you're not learning from it.
You're kicking the dead horse.
Yeah, exactly. Fail fast means you fail, you realize you fail, right? And then you fix it.
Yep.
You try something else.
Correct.
So like I said, it could be in your marketing, it could be in, you know, your
company culture
that we just talked about. Yeah. You know, it could be in all these different ways, but you need to look at it and you need to figure out what, you know, if you're failing at something, how do you fail fast and then move forward from it.
And not let it discourage you.
Yes.
That's the thing, is take any successful person, literally think of any successful person, like megastar, and look at their story. They did not just swing once and hit the home run.
Yeah.
Right? They failed and they failed and they failed and they struggled. And then one time, and someone said that, I can't remember who the quote was from, but they said it only takes one. Right. You can fail a million times, but it only takes once to win.
Right.
And so the only example I can think of somebody just hitting the nail on the head is like that little, there was like a little 14-year-old kid that bought a bunch of Bitcoin back in the day because he played video games, and that's how he'd buy armor for his his thing. And then when Bitcoin blew up, he became like hundreds of millions of dollars or something like that.
There you go.
That kid got lucky. He fell into it, right? But other than that, you take any other example, and they, Babe Ruth,
Yep.
You know, these are all, you know, sports examples, but take anybody, Mark Cuban, all of these guys, they failed, and then one time they got it right. And it changed their life.
Absolutely. But the key is, again, not just doing the same thing and failing at the, you know, over and over and over again and letting it go until until you're dead, until you've ruined the business. The other thing is fail forward. And what that means is that every failure you have gets you one step closer to success as long as you learn from that failure and move forward with that knowledge, right?
Absolutely.
So I want you to think about that for a second. We think of failure as like, oh, I totally failed, right? I lost. Mm-hmm. But there's another way to think about a failure. A failure is not I lost, it's I learned something that I now know, so I'm not going to make that mistake again.
Right.
Right? I mean, think about Michael Jordan. Every time he failed in a game, you know, when he missed that shot, that he, you know, that game-winning shot, he learned from that mistake. And what did he do? He went out and he practiced and he practiced to make sure that that never happened again to him, right? That he didn't make that same mistake. And that's the same thing with business. If you fail forward, you're learning from the mistake you made, and then you're moving forward with that knowledge and applying that to your decisions going forward. And that's how you find success. Mm-hmm. You know, because I think that a lot of times we think of like success is this linear thing. Like I do this, and then boom, success, I found it.
Yeah.
And I don't really think it's like that. To me, success is like I go here, you know, I go a step to the left. Nope, I fail. That didn't work. I go a step to the right. Nope, that didn't work. I go a step up here to the corner, and then I take a step here. Oh, that kind of worked, and I take a step here. And it's these little steps, almost like a map, right? And then I finally find success.
Yeah, it's finding the right path to success. It's not, and you've all heard that, the path to success. The path, that doesn't mean a straight line.
No.
It's a path. And it winds, and you know, and there's other paths that go off of it, and you got to make sure that you stay on the right path, or you find that right path. It's funny because my wife used to say to me, and luckily, see, her dad was an entrepreneur, owned his own businesses, everything, so she kind of knew what came with the territory. But she said, you know, I just thought the older you got, the more money you made. You know, and of course, we're in business, guys. We go through it. We went through COVID. Life goes up and life drops down, and life goes up and life drops down. And so, you know, you can plan and prepare, and it can make things easier. But success is not a straight line.
No,
and it's not a guarantee.
Exactly. All right. And then the final thing I want to talk about, and this is, I'm pretty sure it's my quote, so.
I think you did.
Really, I think I made this one up, but perfection is the enemy of profits.
Mm-hmm.
And what I mean by that is, you know, if you are standing still because you're afraid to fail, you know, then you will never be successful. Mm-hmm. So if you want to be perfect and you don't want to make a mistake in your business, you will never be successful because you will never get anywhere. Because guess what? You're going to take one step forward and you're going to fail. And then you're going to have to step back and you're going to take a step to the, you know, to the right, and you're going to find a little bit of success. So if you're looking for perfection in your business, then you will never be profitable. You will never be successful.
And I love that perfection is the enemy of profits, because if you are waiting till something is perfect, you are losing money. You are losing out on profits. Nothing is perfect. Facebook isn't perfect. Instagram isn't perfect. You know, look at some big businesses. The other day, and I've said this before, I went to go check my bank account and the bank's website was down and they said, we're so sorry. Because guess what? They're not perfect. And you're talking billion-dollar businesses and they're not perfect.
Oh yeah. Imagine if, just talking about Facebook, imagine if Mark Zuckerberg decided not to release Facebook to the public.
Yeah.
Until he had it perfect. He had the ad center in there and the way to buy ads and to do this and to market on it.
He'd have been crushed.
He would
never have launched.
Yeah, Facebook would have never launched.
Yeah.
Right? And it's not perfect. It's not even perfect now, right?
No, it's worse than it used to be.
Yeah. But he launched it, and then along the way, he started making it better and better and better. And that's the same thing with your business, right?
That's exactly right.
You fail forward, you keep moving. All right, Trevor. So anything else before we do the homework?
No, I love it. I mean, just think of your businesses, guys. Like, you didn't start, if you have a pest control company, you didn't start being the best pest control guy in the world, knowing every insect and every, you know, the anatomy of these insects and all this stuff. Like, you learned on the job. You got better as you went, but you started. You took that step, right?
Yep.
That's what we're talking about here. Take the steps, fail forward, and do it fast. Yeah?
All right.
All right. So what are you failing at now? What are you failing at now? What can you learn from that? And how can you take that knowledge and move forward with it? Instead of just being like, because one thing I hate is when people say, oh, I tried, and I say this a lot, oh, I tried Facebook ads, that didn't work, you know, or oh, I tried Google ads, that doesn't work, or I tried SEO, that doesn't work, and that's crap and everything. It's like they tried something once and they just gave up on it, which could kind of go along with, oh, fail forward fast, except for that, that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about that when something's a complete flop, we just move forward and we're moving these little incremental steps, right? So it's like, okay, Facebook, so this is a good clarification so that people don't get confused. Like Google ads. So you launch, you create your Google ads, you launch them, and it fails. It's not working.
Yep.
So instead of scrapping it, failing forward fast would mean, okay, well, you know what? Let me analyze this. Okay, let me tweak this and look. Okay, that worked. Let me tweak this. Ooh, that didn't work. Let me make a quick change. Yes. Ooh, tweak this. Okay, let me, and we're doing that in our own business right now.
Yes.
We got invited into this, you know, super awesome Google Ads hierarchy thing, you know, with Google, and we were on their advanced track team or something like that.
Yeah.
And it didn't work.
Yeah, basically they came to us and they said, oh my gosh, you guys are doing so awesome. We can, you know, 10 times what you're doing.
Yes.
This is not some other company. This is Google directly.
Correct.
Came to us and said, we can 10 times what you're doing. Yes. And it didn't work.
It failed. It didn't work. And so I am now going back and making tweaks backwards and forwards because I did learn. I learned through the failure. It cost us a lot of money, but I learned through it. And so now I'm making these tweaks and I'm getting us back on track. And guess what? We are going to be better because of that.
Yes.
So we are failing forward fast, right? All right, guys, take a look at your business. We love you. We support you. We're here for you. And we will see you next time with Troy and Trevor Howard on So Tell Us Time.